Hiya. You and Cameron believe this is now currently the largest aircraft operating out of Edinburgh. I think with them using the 900, yeah, it's pretty much is. Steve Marchant, good morning. How's the wedding nerves? Yeah, not bad, mate, not bad. Nice close footage, absolutely. Great to be able to catch this. Longest flight from Edinburgh, 7 hours 30 minutes, that's pretty cool. And Heather, welcome to the live stream, good morning. Gonna see an Air France A319 in just a second, folks. WestJet, the spirit of Canada. Great to have them here at Edinburgh Airport here in Scotland. Really nice connection to have. Just going to see Eurowings in a second, folks. It's an Aer Lingus, Scotland. Heading to Washington, I believe I said it. Heading to Chicago, sorry. That's the one. Nope, doesn't look like the Dorneys are going anywhere, sadly. Might be a little bit later on. The United isn't too late. It's fairly on schedule, to be honest. Any chance of the Emirates? Is the Emirates going to resume flying? There is talk about it, yes. I hear quite a lot of talk about Emirates coming back, but we'll see. We'll see what the future holds. Never say never. Next, it looks like we'll have another EasyJet or Airbus coming in. The Ryanair getting in, the Air France pushing back, and the Smartwings, which has just gone as well. Honestly, Edinburgh is such an amazing airport at the moment, so busy. It really is. C-146. United 757 is just sitting waiting there at the moment. Qatar's near the Jeddah now, fantastic, it's not too far. It's supposed to be making an easy departure. Oh, and the United 757 is now taxiing, by the way, folks. United 757 taxiing folks. Love to see the WestJet pilots do a demo vertical tip. John Driscoll, thank you so much, mate. Great stream as always, Jonathan. Thank you. You're more than welcome, mate. And thank you so much for your kind support. It really means a lot, mate. Thank you so much. Oh dear, it looks like the United, unbelievably. Well, you did say it was going to be a rejected takeoff.
Well, I thought it would be something similar.
I think you kind of predicted that. So the United 757, which was stuck due to a technical problem, the United, the crew have apparently just ran out of hours, so the United is now backtracking down the runway and is going to return to stand because the Well, there's either another technical problem with the aircraft or something else. Either way, they are not going anywhere. No luck. No luck at all. Well, the I'm playing spawn with a fellow YouTuber, Sean Ray. Please check out his YouTube channel. He's from Newcastle. And he did predict it was going to be a rejected takeoff. So there you go. Not far from the truth. So that's November 14118, vacating the runway at Edinburgh after getting ready to take off and now is no longer able to. So that's a shame. That's a shame. You feel bad for the passengers, you do, especially when you know that there's a Delta 767 just on the other side there, which, you know, could potentially take them across to the States, but in reality they're probably just about ready to go, so that's a shame. Oh well. Quite a lot of delays earlier, yeah, and yet the sickening part about it is that despite all those delays, the United still hasn't taken off, and he's now about to cause even more problems. So, yeah, a bit of sickening for everyone. Oh well, nothing you can do. Part and parcel of aviation. That's the United, just taxi down to where the 75 and the 76 is. That's a shame. That's a shame. I just hope we manage to get the Delta before our battery level dies. Oh dear. United is phasing out. It is, yep. The A321 is actually on order for the 757, believe it or not, the A321neo. So United shocked everyone when it ordered them. But...